Hi everybody, I am Brian Mullins the Fox, back again to bring you another spooky commentary video this frightful October. Let me prove to you how and why Christmas is sus as hell. First, let's start with Thanksgiving. Obviously, in 1863, Abraham Lincoln declared Thanksgiving a national and federal holiday. Turkey and ham statistics have been well documented year after year after year. For example, from this nationwide blog infographic. Another example is when it comes to food waste on Thanksgiving, according to a News 5 Nashville article published by Eric Hilt. Experts estimate around 200 million pounds of turkey will go to waste this Thanksgiving, as of 2019, that was last year, according to the U.S. Chamber of Commerce Foundation. 40 million pounds of mashed potatoes and 30 million pounds of stuffing will head into trash cans as well. Thanksgiving is big in terms of food waste. I'd argue Christmas is a much bigger term of food waste, Linda Bregan said. Bregan is the program director of the Nashville Food Waste Initiative. She said all that waste adds up and can impact your wallet. Quote, for the average family of four, food waste costs them $1,800 a year, she said, adding that it also takes a major toll on the environment. Quote, about 95% of all of our food waste goes to landfills or incineration, and that's the last place we want it to go. Because when it sits in landfills, it decays and produces greenhouse gases, she said. To put that into perspective, dividing that by 16, which is the average weight of a turkey, that translates to 12.5 million turkeys thrown away each year. Now let's continue with the other side, the much darker side, Christmas. So in two videos I made in the past, debunking consumption statistics, the second one debunking the same old University of Illinois Extension statistic by dividing 736 million pounds of turkey by 16, which is the average weight of a turkey, in which that translated to 67,466,667 turkeys. So then I subtracted 87 million turkeys by 67,466,667 turkeys. At that point, it did not add up to 22 million. I later debunked the Easter turkey statistics for the sake of argument. You can't really take statistics like that at face value. Even when you go deep into it, it's still wrong. The first one simply points out the giant contradiction that supposedly more people consume ham on Christmas than turkeys, even though 88% of Americans eat turkey on Christmas. Wait, what? That's the contradiction. That's the contradiction right there. Do you see how stupid and crazy that is? It's neither turkey or ham in the past. It's children. If it's that level of contradictory stats, then either the data's wrong or the causation is wrong. Thanksgiving isn't having much of any problems showing how much people ate on Thanksgiving. And another screenshot demonstrating the second video shows that 77% of all turkeys sold throughout the year are sold in November, totaling nearly 400 million pounds of turkey in that month alone, according to Nielsen. Ever since then, in Nielsen's 2019 statistic, that went up by 11%. It's, as of then, 88%. The gap is closing in for turkey on Thanksgiving. Something is quite awfully suspicious. Americans can consume 77 million pounds of ham on Thanksgiving, but can't consume them on Christmas because they would rather throw them away because they either execute their plans so poorly, overbuy, and worry about the health risks than to just eat them, or they don't choose to eat ham or turkey altogether on Christmas at all. They'd rather eat their own children if they didn't believe in Santa Claus or some shit like that. Holy fuck. Ham for the holidays? Your Thanksgiving is safe despite a global pork shortage. If the gap is also closing in on ham for Christmas because an international pork shortage is dawning on them. We should have saved so many hams by not wasting them. And if there were starving people in the United States, we should have fucking fed them. It may sound odd, but that might have been the only way to prevent a pork shortage. Also, with coronavirus in the way of Christmas dinner preparations in the future, it'll be more likely that the gap between supposed consumption and waste will fill in, because either people wouldn't bother buying any more ham due to COVID-19, or they would rather have normal dinner instead of a traditional Christmas one. If the latter is true, then Christmas is truly dead in the kitchen. Just like the 18,568,322 children that were literally and anally sacrificed for Christmas dinner after slaughtering them for not believing in Christmas in a phenomenon called the roast game. That is the dark yet basic statistical contrast between Thanksgiving and Christmas. Now, the metaphorical picture has been fully painted. It took years to make it, but we made it. Now all we need is the frame. I'm Brian Mullins the Fox, signing out.